Hello, makers. While looking through my stuff, I found that I have quite a few of those cheap ultrasonic sensors. It's one of the first sensors I bought, and I bought a lot of them. So, let's make a project out of it. It's project day. For this project I need a long piece of wood. It's about 1.35 meters, and I found it in the attic. It's a leftover from a bed, and it's not very straight. And I will also need some Neopixels. Well, before I widely assemble this, I built a prototype with 5 ultrasonic sensors and an Arduino Nano controller, just to see if it's worth the time and effort I will put in. The sensors and the Arduino will share the same common ground and voltage line, and each ultrasonic sensor has its own echo and trigger pin connected to the Arduino. If you're into Arduino, you all should already have played with this sensor. It worked this way that you send a command to this module that emits an ultrasonic impulse and triggers a pin when it receives this pulse again. Usually you measure the time between the outgoing pulse and the incoming pulse with the method pulse in from the Arduino. The problem here is the Arduino waits until the pulse comes in again. This would work fine with one sensor, because we have all the time we need after the pulse goes out for the pulse to receive. But using our setup with 5 sensors, we can't wait for each sensor to send its pulse and receive its pulse. All sensors should work independently. Well, how to achieve this? We could send a microcontroller to each sensor that observes the state of the sensor and send it to a main controller. Way much overflow. What we should do instead, we command each sensor to send its pulse and continuously asking if any of those sensors have received the answer of the pulse, and measure the time for. So we are taking care of the time measurement. Well, lucky me, someone already thought of that and made a library called NewPing. The code is pretty simple. We initialize an array of type NewPing and add all our sensors we need. In the loop function, we loop through the complete array and asking each sensor for its received distance. Let's see if this really works. Well, now we're getting reasonable values. And let's see if we can change one of those values. Well, let's take a closer look. If we take this sensor, this seems to be sensor 4. And it really changed the distance. That's quite cool. Yeah, I would call this a successful test. Well, let's assemble it. Well, the ultrasonic sensor has a diameter about 16 centimeters. That is about the size of the holes I have to drill in. But I need a 16 centimeter drill for it. Well, it looks like I get the best results if I first use the smallest drill and then go right to the biggest drill. Well, it was time to transfer this wiring on the breadboard on a PCB, which looks even wilder from the outside. Well, now I have to solder each of those ultrasonic sensors to a bundle of four wires. Well, that would be fun. I started to solder the connections to the ultrasonic sensors. It's easier if you first tin the wires, and already done two. Three more to go. And I really hope all those ultrasonic sensors and connectors working, because I didn't test any of this. And this would ruin my day. Well, soldering is complete. Let's run a small test to see if some of the connections will work. Since they all have common ground, ground must be connected at... Oh. Well, first problem. And VCC must connect it to each. But there are two ground lines not working properly. I have to check it again. So here's the build. And this is how it works. Each sensor is responsible for coloring several of these LEDs. And if I get close to one of those sensors, those LEDs turn from white to red. This was a quite easy and cheap build. All you need is some ultrasonic sensors. I use an Arduino Nano and some wires and somewhere where you can mount this, all this stuff. If you want to recreate this, I'll leave everything you need down in the description. The only problem I have with this build is fixing this Neopixel stripe. I took this to the maker frame, but it didn't have this much impression as the other projects. But I'm still glad that I built it. Tell me if you built something similar. Until then, be creative and bye.